Once upon a time, far away, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar came to the castle and offered him a sea of rose in return for shelter and a roof over his head. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at her and turned the old woman away. She warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is far away. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's loveliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle for the magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope, for who could ever learn to love a beast?
Thank you. Oh! Where did we get an idea like that? I heard that. I'm gonna ask nicely. step out into a place where I can see you.
Hello!
Die!
And goodbye.
Wait. You are a clock. And you are talking.
I know. Astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye!
Cogsworth! Where are your manners?
We've got to get him out of here before the master finds out. This is amazing. That was accomplished.
Oh, hey. Billy! Sir, Billy, sir, do you mind?
I'm stumped. Must be some kind of newfangled scientific gadget.
I said, not a gadget.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to be rude. I just simply never saw a tuck. A tuck, sir!
Bless you!
Your children's a bon manger. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, Lumiere, I forbid it. As head of this household, I demand that you stop right there. Oh, not the master's chair. Not the master's chair. I'm not seeing this.
Ooh la la, do my eyes deceive me, or is this a real man? It's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lumiere. Bonjour, monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
Hello?
Oh, all right. This has gone on far enough. I'm in charge here, man.
Coming through! How would you like a nice hot cheese, sir? It will warm you up in no time.
Oh, yes, please.
No cheese. You'll be here all night. I said no cheese.
Here you are.
Thank you.
Ah! I think I scared him, Mama. Oh,
sorry, little fella. What's your name?
Chip.
Thank
you. Care for a blanket, monsieur. I just love older men.
Love of it. You are always trying to make me jealous. Well, it's not going to work, sister.
Me? What about you and Simone?
Jacques.
Michelle.
Pierre.
Veronique.
Veronique.
Lumiere, listen to me. Do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out we let a stranger in?
Calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never have to know.
Thank you. isn't it? I'm just full of surprises. For you, mademoiselle.
Ah, I've been at your portrait. How you, very thoughtful.
Don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who wouldn't love to be in your shoes. This is the day your dreams come true.
What do you know about my dreams,
Belle? Plenty.
Well, gee.
Hey, Belle, have you seen Gaston?
You just missed him. Wait a second, where did you get this scarf?
This? Oh, in the woods. Pretty nice, huh?
That belongs to my father.
Yeah, well, finders keepers.
Rude, I want you to think long and hard and tell me exactly where you found that.
No.
Think.
Somewhere in the woods.
Harder!
Near the crossroads, okay?
LeFou, that means something happened. You have to take me back.
Not in those woods again.
He can still be out there somewhere. You have to take me back.
Not in your life.
Then I'll find him myself.
Trust Master.
He's an old man, he could die.
He came into my home. you must promise to stay here forever.
Oh,
forever! Forever! Or he dies in the dungeon!
No, wait, that's not fair! Step into the light.
Make your choice.
Well, I'm old. I lived a life.
You have my word.
Done. Take him to the crossroads.
Oh, please, spare my daughter!
Wait, not yet!
No, 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 no!
Very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Careful, darling!
Who are
I'm sorry.
You see, they've forgotten all about me. One can be, and I won't, the toast of Europe, the greatest star to ever grace the stage, but fall under one little spell.
Wait, this is impossible.
I know it is, but here we are. Well now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice, but how would you like to see what I've got?
No, no, no. Back.
What is it?
Ah!
wasn't there when I went to bed. Where did it come from? Why is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
Just try to relax.
Relax? Relax? How can I relax with this appendage on my back? Is there no dignity left for me? What's going to go next? My mind?
Just try to calm down. It will be all right.
You're frightened, Vivian.
I know, my friend. But you are not alone.
We are all in this together.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
Perhaps I should see about her. Won't be but a minute.
I told her to come down. What's taking so long?
Try to be patient, sir. She's lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you thought that perhaps this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. Not a fool.
Good! Then you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof! Spell is broken. We're human again by midnight.
It's not that easy, Humir. These things take time.
But we do not have time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful and I'm home. Look at me.
He has a point.
Shh.
Master, you must help her to see past all of that.
I don't know how.
Well, you could start by trying to make yourself more presentable. Straighten up. Attempt to act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your rapier wings.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere. And above all.
What?
You must control your temper.
Well, what? Where is she?
Who? Oh, yes, the girl. Well, circumstances being what they are. She's not coming.
What do you say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that.
Your Excellency, Your Majesty, Your Grace.
Stay where you are, Lumiere. Stand aside. I thought I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I'm telling you to come to dinner.
And I'm telling you I'm not hungry.
You're hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What do you say?
Just go around ordering people to be hungry. It doesn't work like that.
I can.
Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude is it? And how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I will drag you by the hair.
Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affections.
Please, can't you see justice?
Why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come to dinner.
So you admit that you're being a bully. Deep breaths, Master. Deep breaths.
I'll give him a last chance. Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please.
No, thank you.
Fine! Let's start!
Master, please!
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all.
What were we thinking? We'll never be human again.
So it appears.
But what would you two have us do? Give up? I can't give up until I hear the sound of my daughter's laughter as she runs through these halls again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. You must give up while we still have a chance. Come here, stand guard at this door, and inform me if anything changes.
Oui, mon capitaine.
I asked nicely, but you're... Show me what you do, Ben. Show me.
Lumiere! Oh, Lumiere!
Ah, Babette! Come to me, my little. you really tickled my fancy.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no, no, no. I've been burnt by you before.
rusting, needing so much more is adjusting, needing exercise, a chance to use our skills.
Thank you.
Don't touch that!
I'm sorry.
What are you doing here?
I
told you never to come here.
No, but...
Do you realize what you could have done? Get out! You have no right to be there. No right!
Don't touch me!
No, I...
Promise or no promise, I won't stay here.
I'm sorry. Come back.
I didn't mean to hurt you.
I didn't mean to frighten you. Ow!
Hurts. Hold still, it wouldn't hurt as much.
Well, if you hadn't run away, none of this would have happened.
If you hadn't frightened me, I wouldn't have run away.
Well, you shouldn't have run in the West Wing.
You should learn to control your temper. Hold still. Stay single. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
You see? I knew they could get along if they tried.
So Zias is broken. At last.
Not long too soon, either. Have you taken a good look at the roads lately? Lucy pedals at an alarming rate.
Not to mention the fact that I can hardly bend over at all anymore.
Clearly, it's time for us to give them a little proof. We must find a nice, romantic way to bring them closer together.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up with a nice bowl of soup?
Soup?
Trust me.
Thank you.
shout. Arthur is king.
Cause several husbands and all wrapped up on his shoulders.
got my heart set on marrying Belle, but she needs a little persuasion.
Turn it down flat.
It's like this, see?
There's a danger from before tonight, and denied my honeymoon. For the pretty thing I courted refuses to swoon. So the time has come for a murky plan, for which I took to the murky mill to find that fiend where better than the Maison de Lune. I don't take this girl for granted. There's no path I have into. I'll no seed unplanted.
Thank you.
off of the cover with you now. It's past your bedtime. Good night, love.
Thank you for inviting me to dinner.
Dinner was wonderful.
Belle, I... Well, are you happy here?
Oh, yes. Everyone's so nice. Mrs. Potts, Lumiere.
Me?
Yes.
I must speak from the...
Sir Hart!
Is something wrong?
I was just thinking about myself. I miss him so much. I wish I could see him again.
There's a way. This mirror will show you anything. Anything you wish to see.
Thank you. I've come to collect your father.
What?
Don't worry, we'll take good care of
him. My father's not crazy.
He was raving like a lunatic. We all heard him, didn't we?
Yeah!
You can't do this.
Now tell us again, old man, just how big was that beast?
Well, he was huge. He was like 10 feet tall.
Don't get much crazier than that.
Come along quietly.
Let go of me!
Now, Maurice, when did you first start having these delusions?
It's not delusions, they're real! It's all the talking clock!
Well, it's a shame to hear about your father.
Gaston, you know he's not crazy.
I might be able to clear up this little misunderstanding. If
what?
If you'll marry me.
What?
One little word, pal, that's all it takes.
Never!
Have it your way. Take the old man.
No!
Wait! I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast.
That's him! That's him! That's him!
Is he dangerous? Oh no, he would never hurt anyone. You know he looks right. He's very kind and sweet. He's my friend.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you have feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston. You are.
She's as crazy as the old man. She says this beast is her friend. Well, I've hunted wild creatures and I've seen what they can do. The beast will make off with their children. He'll come after them in the night.
He would never do that.
Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
Stalking us at night.
Thank you.
simply can't believe it fits again after all these years.
It's getting exhausted.
Did you ever?